Hi guys, Tom here and welcome to this short video on a wheel wash for my Audi S3. You've seen a couple of the other videos, hopefully about one of them we did on painting the brake discs and one we did on cleaning the exhaust tips, but this one today is going to be a bit of a short video on cleaning the wheels and a new product that I've just got that I want to talk about. I'm going to do it quite short because as I'm a little bit new to YouTube and I'm just getting into this sort of video editing, I didn't realise the others had gone in like 20 minutes, but I'm going to do this a nice quick one. So let's get over to the products that we're going to use today. Okay guys, so let's talk about some of the products we're going to use today. And there's this really new, first thing I want to talk about is this glove. Now I've got this from Halfords, it's new to their product range, and obviously it's a glove that you can wear, and I'll put it on in a minute to show you. It looks really cool, and as a lot of you will know, it's very difficult to get in and around these small sort of alloys. Well, not the small bits, but the crevices of behind here, behind the brake caliper, and when you're trying to get like a microfiber pad in there or even a brush, it can be difficult. Personally, I don't like using brushes because I don't like to damage the wheel. And the wheels, albeit it's a two-year-old car, they're in great condition, so I don't want to damage them. The next thing is some Bilberry wheel cleaner. I love this stuff. It's really great. Valet Pro makes loads of product, solution rather, when you mix it up. I mix it in here. Admittedly, I don't really go by the instructions exactly. I just put like about half an inch or an inch in the bottom, and it works out great. Next thing, obviously, just a couple of brushes if we can't get into all of the areas. Then I go over to like the two bucket method. Some people would say two bucket is quite excessive for wheels, but personally, you know, I haven't used two bucket before, but now I've got these sort of quite new good looking wheels. I want to keep them good, so I've got my grit guards in some two buckets. They're not the best buckets, and I've got better ones for actually the main wash. They're not that deep, but they're good enough. So you'll see me using those in a minute. I always just put a little bit of Auto Glims, my sort of favourite shampoo, whether or not it's rated that highly by professional detailers, but I kind of like it and I use that solution as well. So we'll start off, we'll use the Bilberry cleaner, then we'll jet wash, then we'll do the two bucket with the mitt. Get that mitt soaking actually in there right now. And then my other favourite Auto Glim product, actually second favourite, my favourite Auto Glim product is the Rapid Detailer. I love that stuff and I'll talk about that another time. But this is my second favourite, it's the Instant Tire Dressing. Really great, put it on wet or dry and it gives a great shine. So let's get set up over here and start applying the product. Okay, so when I put on this spray, I always go crazy with it. I put loads on, and you can see I'm just going to move right in here that they're not even that dirty. And the more you spray on, the better. It almost just lifts off the dirt straight away. So let's get loads of this on. As a health and safety aspect, if it was really windy, I'd wear goggles with this, but I'm keeping up out of the way, get my eyes out of the way, and just put plenty on up under here, all around here, and on the brake discs that you see I painted the other day. I also do the tyres as well, guys. Just, I don't know whether everyone else does tyres, but always add a bit on there to the tyres. And generally, I leave that to kind of set for, I say 5 minutes. If it's a hot day, it's actually kind of winter now, but if it was a hot day, I'd leave it for maybe a little longer, but 5 minutes. So we'll leave that and then we'll come back to it. Okay guys, so ideally you don't want this stuff to really dry on. You can see it's really lifted that off really nicely and it's just running down there. The back wheels never get that dirty. I try and wash the car once a week, so hardly need any on the back wheels, if any at all. So we go over now, get the pressure washer ready. I haven't done a review on this pressure washer yet because it's quite old, but we'll get the pressure washer ready and get ready to blast all of that off.
Chris.
Okay guys, so we're ready with a two bucket here. Oh, let's just wipe the lens off a bit so we can see. People might think that, you know, it cleans the wheel just by doing the pressure wash, but I always like to do something more. There is a little bit of still some stuff here you can see, and you're never going to get right the way around the back and everything. When you get the right angles here, you can get up underneath here, because this is always the bits that get neglected and looks rubbish if you don't get these good. So let's try out this new glove now, and I've never used this before, so bear with me. Notice I've got my blue gloves on underneath this. This glove, it is pretty cold and it isn't hot water I've got. Obviously I would encourage you, if you do have hot water, to use it. Wow, this looks really cool. And it is really cool. I'm really quite excited to use this. Already this is making life a lot easier to get onto those neglected areas, like round the back of the spokes. Before I would have never really got right round the back here, or on this brake disc, so I'm really pleased with this result. Okay guys, as you can see, that's looking really nice, really clean, tyres looking good. Quite pleased actually, that Bilberry wheel clean looks really good. The bucket, although it's just is not actually that dirty, and the wash one is also is not that dirty, as is the glove. So I'm going to crack on now, do the other three wheels, and then we'll come back and do a jet wash off, and then dress the tires later. That's the rinsed finish. Looks pretty good. I would usually put on the auto glim tire dressing, obviously, after I've washed the rest of the car. So I'm going to come back to that one and do it a little later. You can put that on kind of wet or dry. It doesn't really make a difference. I tend to do it sort of semi-wet, so most of the water's dried off. Okay guys, so I've got the auto glim tire dressing here, and I'm just gonna apply that quite liberally. It's semi wet, there's still some wet spots, but in realistic terms that doesn't actually matter. So we'll start applying. This stuff goes really white. I'm gonna stand back a bit so I don't get it all over the camera. Apply it quite liberally. What I usually do with this one is just leave that now. Leave it to sort of set, let it all drain off. It doesn't seem to matter if you get it on the actual wheel itself. And then I come back just with a microfiber cloth and just sort of touch up any spots on the alloy itself. So we'll leave that now and come back to it in a few moments. Okay guys, so pretty much done here. I've wiped around the tire now with some cloth. And it's given a really nice matte finish here. If I wanted to get a shinier finish, I'd use like a tyre gel, but this auto grim spray is my favourite to give a nice kind of a matte, okay, just a new tyre finish. And I've just sort of polished off any of the dirt on this alloy and we're about done. So let's go back over to the product. I just want to touch up on this tyre glove again, and I think this is really great, and it was only £4 from Helfords. But yeah, it has done a really good job. It got into 95% of the places. Couldn't quite get behind one of the brake calipers on the front, but really good buy. Hopefully it will last sort of at least 6 months. That's about it for this one. It's really short. One thing I will make a note of is don't use the same buckets. If you're just getting into this kind of amateur detailing, don't use the same buckets that you did to do the wheels, because it's just not a good idea and you're going to scratch up your car and everything. So I've got some more professional buckets for doing the rinse and the clean of the car. Anyway, we're going to get on to doing the clean in a minute. That's for another video. I've just left it soaking in some citrus pre-wash. But the tyre's done, guys, so thanks for watching, and yeah, please subscribe, check out any of my videos, and we're going to do some other sort of full details, a bit of a test drive of the car and everything. But thanks again for watching, and speak soon.